My man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Tuesday. And don't forget, folks, Basil does an outstanding show here every trading day, 10 to 11 Eastern Standard Time. Also, it's a great newsletter, the opening call. Now, it's very easy to get the opening call, folks. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to go right under newsletters to see the opening call on the left-hand side. You just hit the opening call. You're going to hit subscribe. You can get Basil's great newsletter every trading day for $149 a month. You can get it for 6 months for $6.95, which is the savings of $199 or 22%. And you can get it for 1 year for $11.95, where you save $593 or 33%. Now, what you're also getting, folks, is this. Basil has about 10 webinars on there, okay? So you're going to get all the webinars. You're going to get a great newsletter. We get the Thanksgiving holiday. You get 4 days that you can go through all of these webinars, folks. So check it out. Get a great education where you're sitting at home watching some football, having some fun. It's a beautiful thing. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Well, Thanksgiving is always one of those holidays. It really is a beautiful thing, that's for sure.
It is, man. Gobble, gobble, gobble.
I know.
I can't wait. Making stuffing, gravy.
Oh, yeah. This, I'm looking forward to it as well.
And, you know, I haven't been eating meat for almost a year, but I'm going to eat turkey. But then I'm not going to eat any more meat again. But I'm going to eat turkey tomorrow, folks. That's the bottom line.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Okay, so what are we doing here?
So what we're looking at is a rotational market. We've seen these corrections a number of times for the last many years, but certainly even over the last year. When one sector has had a huge move to the upside, it tends to take a rest, and another sector takes its place. So what I'd say to subscribers is, you remember I'd spoken to you about the high that was made in the Dow on the 8th of November at 36,565. We had actually started a short position about 40 points off that all-time high on that day within an hour or so of the high, and we've taken profits out of that. And what we're looking at is, in this rotation, we've seen that the Dow and the IWM, the Russell 2000, have pulled back very sharply. But the S&P and the QQQ, the Index 100, are making all-time highs. Within that context, I always say that the SMHs, semiconductors, kind of go with the QQQ, the Index 100, and they really the it's kind of the engine of that particular sector, of the tech sector, so that most of the time you see the SMHs go to mostly, not always, but most of the time you see them go to all-time highs, either leading or just following after the NDX and QQQs making a high, and they pull back. So I said to subscribers, based on my work, based on a whole bunch of techniques that I look at, here's one that I'll just discuss. This is pattern that I use trend lines, and if it makes a little mini channel, that's different to the larger channel, a wide channel. This is a very narrow channel, about 3/16 of an inch, joining all the highs, or it could be joining the lows. And if the price gets close to that, it often gets repelled. And so my thinking was that on Friday going into Monday, that we would see some kind of a high in the SMHs, in the QQQ, that's the Index 100. So we took short positions, and we actually now have short positions based on Chapman Wave methodology, not really just technicals, because the technicals, the 9-period moving average is still above the 14. On my show, and I'll do this again for those of you who are new to my work, I'll do it tomorrow in my show. I'll discuss what I look at. And you can see that on the left side, the 5th of November high of 400.99 on the QQQ. Look how strong the MACD, the moving average convergence divergence was. This bottom one here is the stochastic, the slow stochastic, up in the 90%, 95% area. On balance volume was very good. And the 9-period moving average, this little green line in the daily chart on the left, was way above the 14. And I had said, as we're going towards these highs over the last 2 days, look, the MACD is coming down, the stochastic's pulling back under 80%, on balance volume's pulling back. I have to be aware that the 9-period moving average over the 14 is still a positive, but every other part of the Chapman Wave methodology, from the 120-minute chart to the little doji candle, I call it the silent doji, just before a turn in the market, indicated that there could be some kind of a digestive phase. And that's all I can call it because it's a daily chart. Weekly charts are still very strong. So that to me is a start. And it said that what I'd say to subscribers is there's a chance that the Dow actually has a nice rally, maybe even the Russell 2000. While they do that, the S&P and the QQQ and perhaps the SMHs, the semiconductors, could have a bit of a pullback. I always say a bit of a pullback because we don't know until you start to decisively break those key support levels whether it's going to be deeper than just a small turn. So far, the pattern says, ooh, this is, you were talking about it a little earlier, it's a little unusual to make an all-time high and then have a reversal like we saw yesterday and then followed through with a red candle. So the day is young. We've still got 35 minutes. Anything can happen, as you know. But I suspect that we're in for this rotation. So for our other positions, which is really quite interesting, is we have some stocks that are actually going to highs as we speak, or all-time highs, or close to recovery highs. Here's Bank of America. We're still long from the 31 area. It's at 47, 45. It hit 48, 69 the other day and pulled back. We've got a number of other stocks as well. We've got, DBA. I've often spoken to you about this. This is the DB Agricultural Fund. It has wheat, it has corn, it has soybean and sugar. Look at this. A new recovery high, not an all-time high that was up in the 30s, but it's we're long from the 13 area, and here it is at 20.30 in leg E, broke above this particular. Remember, I was just talking about that repellent zone, this tiny little narrow channel, how the price can so often get there and then reverse. Look how many times since the high back in, I think it was May, around about $19.30. Look how it's just a slightly rising mini channel. And look how the price got repelled. So these are techniques that I like to use. Yeah. I'll discuss more of them tomorrow in my show.
That says food is going to continue higher. I mean,
you know, you and I spoke. How many times have we spoken about inflation? I don't know what the Fed looks at or any of the statistics when they come to measure inflation. But anything you go and buy is just way higher than it was. And I think it's going to have a little bit of an impact on the general market at some point. But in the meantime, this is what's telling us. The DB Agricultural Fund, DBA is the symbol. It's up 14 cents today, 20.30, making a new recovery high. And that just says to me that, you know, we've got to be a little careful. We've got to be very selective. We are still long. One of the ones that I've liked for some time, TMO, this is Thermo Fisher Scientific Medical Equipment. It's at 631, all-time high is 651 just a week ago, but it's up near the highs. I'm watching to see how these stocks react over the coming week, but I suspect that we've got some kind of a rotation going on here, and that part of that should probably involve the QQQ, NDX 100, and probably the semiconductors. You know, what's interesting, you know, I like to look at round numbers. Look at this. NVIDIA makes an all-time high. It goes to 346.47 yesterday, but it had a 319 round number low. Applied Materials, great semiconductor, made it 159.00 all-time high, and now it's trading at 148. So I watch this very close. Isn't that interesting?
It is. I like it. You have a great one, a safe one, Basil. We look forward to the show tomorrow and have a great Thanksgiving, man.
You too. Have a wonderful Thanksgiving.
Bye-bye. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.